Good everyone, we'll be simulating the low suction features differential pressure, or that means our low suction features is dirty, and how we'll be going to rectify this problem or this trouble as we watch deeper. So we'll be simulating this through the Kongsberg simulator. So I will run now the simulator. I press F1. So actually we have two screens that we can utilize for the simulator. So this this is the first screen, and we have another screen. So what's the use? So, as a watchkeeper, since there's no alarm yet, we can view it through the process overview if there are any alarms indicated in our system. So far, the systems are good. So, the generators, we have two generators running. We have DG1, DG2 based in this process overview. Okay, DG1 is running and DG number 2 is also running. And our main engine is also running condition and no alarms. The same with the diesel generator, no alarm. Auxiliary boiler is running or is in operation and there's no alarm. So let's check other systems. So let's check.
Warning, fluctuating CHS differential pressure.
Okay, there is an alarm. So there's a fluctuating pressure, differential pressure of our water. So proceed immediately to the water system, and as you can see, there is an alarm of the low differential pressure, so high. So let's open this valve, high suction, then close the valve for the low suction. So this is the high suction switches, and this one is the low suction switches. So since there is a high differential pressure, so we close this valve, then rectify the problem, or we clean the closed switches. So just click this malfunction button, okay? The third malfunction button. Then let's see if the low suction switch alarm dirty. So let's check if this is inactive. So this must be active. Click. So it's active, then reset. So active. So there is an indication of active. So reset active alarm, so since our low suction switches is dirty. So we click reset, then confirm reset. So I do it again, so low suction switches dirty to that, click. So it's already passive, that means the malfunction is already, that means we already cleaned the switches by clicking this reset button to simulate the cleaning of the low suction switches filter. Okay, so we now change over back to low suction switches. Okay, so from high, first please open, don't close it. Please first open the low suction switches. Okay, to maintain flow of seawater. Okay, open this valve. Then there's already pressure. Then close.
High differential pressure. Dirty seat chest.
Okay, there's still a high differential pressure. So immediately open again this high switches suction valve. Okay, then close again the closed switches. Okay, then let us see if there is still not an alarm. So closed switches filter dirty. So let's click the reset. Click, then it will state reset active malfunction. So click again to reset or clean the closed switches suction filter. Then now attempt to reset passive function. Then click again. Reset. That is simulating in cleaning the. Okay, it's already up passive. That means you already cleaned the low suction switches.
Plastics blocking the low seat chest filter. Remove and clean the blocked seat chest.
Okay. So another alarm. Another warning. So let's say there is a black plastic in our low switches. So let's click again. And once this disallow low switches blocked by plastic. So click the reset. Okay, there is an active malfunction, that means it's dirty. So click again. Okay. So this is already passive malfunction, that means you already rectified the malfunction, or that means we already removed the plastic. So that is already good. So that means this low suction filter is already cleaned, or we can switch over back to low CCS. So let's open first this valve. It's open.
Warning, high differential pressure, dirty seat chest.
Okay, again the alarm is okay. This say the differential pressure is 0.11. So then, since the low suction switches is already open, so let's try to close the high suction switches. Close, then monitor the differential pressure is now 0.21. So we see it's not will not increase or reach differential pressure about 0.8. So it must be less than 0.8. As much as possible, it's just 0.21 is okay. Then monitor the pressure of the seawater. So this is the pressure 1.68, so that is good. So it must be 1.6 and above. And this is our seawater pump suction pressure. This is the pressure. This is the seawater pressure from switches going to the pumps. This is good. This is the normal pressure. So the differential pressure is about 0.21, okay, bars, so which is good. So let's just monitor this one, that it will not reach or it will not increase. So it must be less than 0.8. So 0.21 is good. It means our low suction switches is clean or really clean. Okay, then let's monitor the plant. So we can use the process overview to check if there are alarms. So far there are no alarms in other system, such as the diesel generator 1 and 2, and also with our engine and the rest of the auxiliary machineries that we have. Okay? So we will perform housekeeping. If there are alarms, so we immediately rectify alarms or acknowledge the alarm. Okay? So far there are no alarms indicated, okay? Which is good. So since we immediately take actions, or the load differential, that means the differential type differential pressure of our low suction switches. Okay, so immediately if there are problems like that, so rectify it immediately as soon as possible, acknowledge then rectify it. Okay, so that we will have no other alarms with me trigger. So if you reach more time, or that means there is a delay in the rectification of alarm, such as the cleaning of the low suction switches or the changeover, it may result to starvation of cooling seawater. It will trigger high temperature, then blackouts, then shut down the main engine, since there will be blackout. Okay, so that is why we keep good monitoring as a much keeping function. Okay, so let's monitor other our machineries, running machineries. Okay, good. DG1 is good. Digital generator number 2 is good. So our time now is for simulation is 8:55. We are given 10 minutes. It means you have just 1 minute, about 1 minute to finish this exercise, this assessment. So we're waiting, so let's check the machinery is good. DJ number 2 is good for our main engine. So also good, so no alarms. So go back to the water system. So until we reach this time. So the differential pressure for our low suction switches is still 0.1, that means it's normal. It's good. Pressure is 1.68 going to the seawater pump, so it is good. Okay, must be more than 1.6. or 1.6 more. This is good. So we are good to go. So time, we almost reached the time. So it's, I guess we have complied with this exercise regards to low suction seat.